Adobe Max just happened, and it was the biggest leap Photoshop has seen yet, thanks to, you guessed it, AI. Adobe Firefly is the backbone of all the major Adobe updates this year, unsurprisingly, including Generative Fill in Photoshop. And with it comes a new context bar, one of the most prominent changes to Adobe's UI in at least a decade, if not more. But while AI stole the show, we also got some much-needed updates to both gradients, they're dynamic now, and improved adjustment layers, which I'm very happy about. Making Photoshop more user-friendly and intuitive is the name of the game for Adobe going into the new year. They made that very clear. So let's look at the top updates for Photoshop from Adobe Max 2024. The new Generative Fill tool powered by Adobe Firefly is the current crown jewel of Photoshop and probably one of your new favorite tools. The go-to for Generative Fill is adding details. All the images used today are found on Envato Elements, by the way. You can find the links below, but more on Elements a little later. So, Generative Fill is incredibly intuitive. Just select the area where you want to add a detail. Type in what you want to add. Descriptor words are recommended here. And then all you gotta do is hit generate. A generative fill will use the existing pixels to match lighting and perspective, as well as the shape of the selection itself. It'll give you three options at a time, and you can generate more or just adjust the prompt and try again. This is all taking place right in the properties panel. But while heading things is super fun, we can also prompt it to remove details. Just select what you want removed and tell it to, in this case, remove the earring. And generate. Everything remains on its own layer, so we still have the power to edit, refine, you know, do some blending, and just be as precise as we need to be. But it doesn't stop there. You'll find the new fill options in the crop tool. By choosing Generative Expand, we can expand images past their original size, and Firefly will fill in all that empty space. This works particularly great with detailed landscapes and is one of the most exciting uses for Generative Fill, for me at least. I mean, it's basically a reverse crop. So cool. But even more remarkable is that we can now use Generative Fill to combine two existing images. We have this gap between these two layers here. Let's select that. Hit generate without adding a prompt this time, and it'll fill the space between the two images, connecting them seamlessly, shaving hours off of compositing. Now, while not mentioned in the Adobe Max keynote, a credit system will be coming to Generative Fill inside of Photoshop starting November 1st, and the amount of credits you'll get will depend on your Adobe Cloud plan. I guess nothing is free, even when you paid for it. We're moving on to the new floating context bar. It's not just where Generative Fill lives, as we've already seen. It's a whole new way to interface with some of the most common tools in Photoshop. With a selection tool active, we get a Generative Fill options, of course, but we also get easy access to our modify selection options like expand and contract, which is very nice. We have our invert selection button right here. We can create a mask from selection, and of course, more. But like I said, it's all contextual, so it changes. If we select a mask, we get new options relevant to editing masks. If we add text, we get our go-to text options. I really hope they keep expanding and improving on the context bar. It makes navigating Photoshop much more manageable, especially for beginners and intermediate users. Moving on to gradients. They're dynamic now. Yes, after 30 years, you no longer have to click repeatedly to get that perfect gradient. It was truly horrible. The gradient tool is now fully dynamic. We create a gradient just like we would have before. But now we can use these different anchors to adjust the spread, shape, and angle, all by clicking and dragging. We can also switch between styles, gradient presets, and individual colors without redoing our gradient, all while still having access to our standard gradient properties if we really need to fine-tune them or we need a specific color or angle. And the best part is that gradients aren't just dynamic, they're now non-destructive, completely. You can edit using these anchors until you rasterize the gradient layer itself. I'm so happy about that. I've been waiting for this update for literally years. I cannot believe it hasn't happened sooner. I've been working with Photoshop for a long, long time, and Envato Elements has been the best value resource library I've ever found. But honestly, it's also just a great place to just fight off creative block and get the inspirational juices flowing. Unlimited downloads with no credit system means I can just download anything that catches my eye, which can be a lot, and just freely experiment. I create collections based on aesthetics that I'm into at the moment. I can just tap into those when I need an extra dose of inspiration, and that actually ends up saving me time even with client work. If I know the vibe they're going for, I already have kind of a place to start. Grab the assets I've used here today, or completely different ones, using the link down below. Next up, adjustments got a significant facelift. The adjustments panel is now a vertical and much more straightforward, and frankly, user-friendly, with our single adjustments laid out clearly. No more mysterious icons. But if we look at the top here, we will see brand new adjustment presets. Now we have a few here, but if we click on more, we actually have several presets to choose from. All of them have live previews if you hover over them. Very nice touch. And if we choose a preset, the individual adjustments inside that preset will be created and grouped, where we can then further dial in on our settings and just mask away. Adjustments were in a desperate need of a refresh. Very happy with this one. Photoshop is now online. A Photoshop Online is Adobe's in-browser photo editor. It's really aimed and propped up to be the streamlined version of Photoshop, perfect for beginners and just really quick edits. And yes, it includes generative fill tools. In fact, it heavily relies on them. Now, Photoshop Online is not free, but it is included in all Photoshop Creative Cloud plans. So if you already have Photoshop, you can hop online and give it a try. And this is leaving us with Adobe Firefly itself. Adobe's image AI generator continues to be updated and improved upon, now going from Firefly Model Image 1 to Image 2. Though still in beta, Image 2 offers a new match image style where you can choose a reference image. Firefly will then use that image as a reference when creating your prompt. And then we also have the new photo settings where you can adjust things like aperture, shutter speed, and field of view. It's clear that 2024 is the year of the AI, and Adobe made it even more clear that they are only getting started. If you have a favorite update, I'd love to hear it below. I'm still really interested in seeing how far Adobe takes Firefly, though I love the little updates to gradient tools, adjustments, and that context bar. Or maybe you have an announcement and update you weren't too happy about, and I'd love to hear about those as well, because sometimes that's just a little bit more interesting. And you can always put those updates to good use by checking out some of our other videos that Envato Tech Plus has to offer. If you liked this video, consider giving us a like and even subscribing if you still need to. And remember to click the little bell icon to be notified of all new videos, including tips, tricks, and tutorials. Happy designing! See you next time!